Hello, my name is Stanislav, and in this video we're going to cover what to do if your proxy does not work on Multilogin. Here we have created a test browser profile for us just to test, so now let's try to launch it. It's going to take some time to launch because it is trying to connect to the proxies. Here we can see it says can't open session and failed to get IP data. So that means that the proxies in this browser profile do not work. And now let's try to see if this was the reason why we couldn't start this browser profile. For this, let's click three dots here and click Edit. Go over to your proxy tab over here. And here we can see our proxy details. It's a SOX 5 proxy, its address and port. And now let's try to check it again. Here it says connection test failed, so that means that this was the reason why we couldn't start this browser profile. And now we need to understand if there is something wrong with the proxies or the application. And for this, we will need to check these proxies outside the multilogin environment. In order to do this, let's open our start menu here and start typing proxy. Here in the search field below, open your proxy settings over here and scroll down to manual proxy setup. Click on and copy your proxies from the application, the IP and the port as well. Make sure that these two do match, the IP and the port. Click save here and close this window. So basically what we've just told our windows is to connect through this IP and this port instead of our actual ones. And now we need to open a browser that is set to default in our system. That is important because it might not work in a non-default browser. So for me it's Chrome, let's try to open it. Here it is trying to connect to google.com and says no internet and error proxy connection failed. So that means that those proxies are not good and they cannot be used anywhere, not on multilogin nor on any regular browser. And actually there are a couple of reasons why this could be happening. We wrote them down here. Just for a better understanding. And the first reason is quite basic, so there could be a typo in your proxy details, such as hidden spaces, extra symbols, and so on. For example, if I put admin here and put an extra space after it, it will always count as an extra symbol and it will always give you connection test failure. The same is here. There shouldn't be any extra details and the password as well. So if there are any extra spaces or extra details, just remove them like so. And try to check your proxy again. And make sure that you're using all of the credentials that were given to you by your proxy provider and there shouldn't be any extra details in it. And the second reason here is that your proxies could have expired. As we all know, all proxies have a limited time of use. It could be 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, and so on. So if your proxies had been working before but stopped all of a sudden, it means that they expired and cannot be used anymore. Or it could be so that the proxies were not valid from the very beginning. It could have happened due to the fact that you were given wrong proxy details by your provider, such as wrong IP or port or wrong login credentials. So whereas the first reason is quite easy to troubleshoot, we will just need to remove any extra spaces or extra details in our proxy information. But for the second reason, you will have to contact your proxy provider directly. And here it leads us to our conclusion that we wrote down as well. So, if your proxy does not connect through a regular browser either, it is a proxy-side issue. And in this case, you will need to contact your proxy provider directly. Usually, proxy provider contact info is displayed on their official website, so it shouldn't be too hard to find. And when you will be contacting your proxy provider, just give them some screenshots and tell that these proxies do not work, and they should be able to give you some new proxies for you to test. So that was the first case for us to cover. And now let's move on to the second one. The second one is quite different. What if your proxy does not connect on Multilogin, but it works on a regular browser like we've just tested before. So it means that the proxy provider did not give the proxy information to the application, and in this case, it has to be filled in manually. So let's try to fill it manually now. For this, we will have to go to time zone, untick this button, and enter the time zone of our proxies. So for example, if we are using Berlin proxies, we will need to find it here and put it here as well. For your proxies, you will be using your location because this is just an example. After this is set, let's go over to WebRTC tab, untick this field, and enter the public IP of your proxies, like so. Again, this is just an example, and you will be entering your proxy details that were given to you by your provider. And after this is set as well, we will need to go to geolocation tab and tick this field and enter latitude and longitude of our proxy location. So for Berlin, I would be entering Berlin location, and for your proxies, you will be entering yours. Also, keep in mind that both latitude and longitude can be found on Google, so it shouldn't be too hard to fill in these fields. After all of three options are filled here, time zone, WebRTC, and geolocation, click Update Profile here. I won't click it now because I didn't fill the information, but you will need to click this button. After this is set, try to start your browser profile again. And if it launches with your new proxies, your new location, then everything is perfect and it is working as intended. But if it does not work either, please contact our customer support and we would be more than happy to assist you on this case. Hopefully, this tutorial was helpful for you and that it would help troubleshoot proxy issues in the future. Thank you so much for your attention.